it's kind of hot. I kind of want to rub his bald head a little bit. Just, you know, not in a creepy way, but just like through the shine, you know what I'm saying? So I want you to put your hands together for Pablo Schroeder!
Good evening. How are you doing out there? Having fun? Cool. Well, my name is Pablo Geronimo Schroeder. I chose that name myself because I thought it was a simple, common German name. So anyway, I need to apologize first of all, start off with, I'm an American. I'm sorry. Well, I'm sorry about Afghanistan, Iraq, and most of all, Britney Spears. So anyway, I came from a great prairie state of North Dakota, and my dad came from a long line of farmers there, and Catholic farmers. They produced mostly durum wheat, barley, but mostly actually kids. My grandpa had 11 children, actually. Now, my dad wanted a few children of his own, so he married my mom, which is common back there. Now, Protestant mom only wanted one child, so they compromised and had 1 dozen and a half, no shit, 18 children in 21 years. 11 boys, 7 girls, no twins. I was born in the middle, lonely, lost, and forgotten. I guess Dad didn't realize that the only thing on the farm that was fertile was Mom. And Mom, well, she didn't put the dots together soon enough. And or her legs. But you know, there was many Schroeders in North Dakota. Prostitutes in our family, unwed mothers, and carjackers. Really, they should have their own city. Call it Surrey. Now, a little bit about my own childhood. 10 months after I was born, they brought home the next boy. 10 months. They named me Paul Jerome. They named him Jerome Paul. No, that's not shit. That's crazy. I mean, that's identity theft. Not only that, he stole all mama's milk. Yeah, that's tough. That's why I'm a little short shit. And, I wanted to get the hell... I got the hell out of there just as soon as I could afford to have a place of my own and could drive a car and was mature enough. It was hard living last year. Anyway, no laugh if they're at that one, I guess. Cross out that one. So, you know, being from such a big family, I wanted to be a somebody, really important. So I actually studied the Catholic priest.
Oh, yeah.
But then I thought, wait a second, I'll be on my knees all the time. That is stupid. So I instead of became a carpenter. But being a carpenter, being in the seminary all the time without a woman, you know, I was horny. Actually, I still am. That's not really funny. That's just good information for all you available women. That's right. So, but being American, I can still go back to the States. And just 3 weeks ago, I was going back to I was going back to the States, and the woman boarding guard said,
"So what are you going to do down here?" She had quite a voice.
And I said, "Well, I'm going up the mountains."
Why?
Well, my girlfriend told me to take a hike. And, she laughed too. But she strip searched me anyway. I guess she's just looking for more humor. Yeah, I know, a small one. So anyway, let's see. left. So while I was down there, I went to this fancy hotel, and it was called Hotel Bellwether. And I came in, the urinal flushed, the sink came on, hand towel came down, hand dryer came down, almost all at the same time. I got scared and got the hell out of there. Really? Because I thought if I sat down in the toilet, a tube would come up and chuck the shit right out of me. And then, not only would I be scared, I'd be scared shitless. Good evening, folks.